So I already talked this week about the fact that Judge Eileen Cannon has set the start date for Donald Trump's trial on the 37 federal counts for August 14th. Now, that date is not going to stand. Like, that trial is totally 100% not going to begin on August 14th. It is going to be delayed. Trump's team has already made it clear we're going to appeal everything we can in the process to slow it down. But in the off chance that this trial does begin on August 14th, and it's supposed to be a two-week trial, so it would not conclude until August 28th. Do you know what happens right smack dab in the middle of that trial? The very first Republican presidential debate for 2024. So while Donald Trump is scheduled to be in court fighting for his life, all of his political opponents will be on a debate stage in Milwaukee telling the entire Fox News audience why they should be the Republican nominee for 2024. Again, these two events will only overlap if there are not significant delays in the trial. But there still is a chance that Trump could be in court while these people are on stage saying why people should vote for them and not Trump. And I think at that point, if that happens the way it is scheduled to happen, do you even really have to make that case? Like, how could any Republican voter in the country, aside from the diehard MAGA people, right? I get it. But aside from those idiots, how could anyone look at a Republican debate stage and see all these people, except for Donald Trump up there, knowing that Trump instead is sitting in trial? I mean, granted, it'll be at the end of the day. The court date for that day will be over. Trump will be sitting at his house watching that trial or the debate unfold. But come on. Like, here's what I don't get. And it's kind of hilarious how incompetent these Republican candidates are, is because y'all are being handed gold, right? Especially if that criminal trial is happening while you're up on that debate stage. Like, you could not ask for better ammunition with which to take down your opponent. But the question is, how many of them will actually talk about it? We know Chris Christie will, but there's a good chance Chris Christie's not even going to make it to the debate stage. He's having trouble getting small donors, and if he doesn't have 40,000 of them, he can't go. So the one guy that you know would call out Trump for being on trial is probably not going to end up on that debate stage. Trump definitely won't be on it, right? He's already made it clear, like, I don't want to participate. I've clinched it. Well, no, you haven't. And the outcome of that trial is really going to determine whether or not you're even going to be on the ballot in most of these states by that point. Things are not going well for Trump, and his opponents are being handed the easiest attacks in the history of politics. It'd be like if Richard Nixon ran for office after he resigned. Like, that's how damning all of this stuff is. And those Republicans will be up on that debate stage. And if they don't have the courage to bring it up while they're on stage, even if the trial hasn't started yet, even if it's been delayed, if they don't bring it up, then they ought to just drop out of the race right now.
Thanks for watching, everyone, and well, here comes the awkward part at the end of the video where I ask you to like, comment, and share, and subscribe for more content from Ring of Fire. Also, you should consider becoming a member for some exclusive content and perks, including early access videos and exclusive videos. Check out the link in the description.